Good morning. Good morning. Today we are going to start with another new topic, which is CSS. Can anyone say that what do you mean by CSS?
Cascading style sheet.
Cascading style sheet. For what purpose we need to use the CSS? What is the purpose of using the CSS?
To make web page more effective.
Yes, to make our web page more effective, or that it is used for our presentation purpose. Presentation is nothing but looks for our, if a page it should be effectively, it looks. Same thing here, which I've explained for you just now, it is next. The primary intention of our CSS was to separate out the web content from the web presentation. Like, suppose we have, in this particular page, I have some paragraph, one paragraph I have. For this paragraph, I have some properties, like my font family should be in the Times New Roman. This paragraph should be visible in the font color with the some red color. The paragraph with this background color, we should be in the orange color. I have some this type of some properties I have. Now I cannot apply to this particular paragraph. So what should I do? I need to separate the content from the presentation. So at that time, we are going to make use of this CSS. Next, various elements such as text, font, color are used in the CSS presentation purpose. Just now what I've said for the paragraph tag. Okay, now, what are the benefits of your CSS? Can anyone say? What are the advantages of your CSS, cascading style sheet? Improved control over formatting. Like the person who is developing the web page, he is going to have a more control overing of that particular contents. Okay, we have given more permissions to that particular author who is going to be developing for that. Improved site maintainability. What do you mean by improved site maintainability? Why we have said that improved site maintainability, in the sense, when we have hosted the document, so when we have hosted our project, at that time in the formatting of the centralized document, or formatting of the document will be in the centralized, so where we can easily extract and we can maintain our sites. Next, improved download speed. What do you mean by an improved download speed? Once we have maintained all the CSS documents into your centralized file, then we can easily extract all the documents with the single click. So for that, we have said that it is an improved download speed. Next. Output flexibility. What do you mean by an output flexibility? Where we have a CSS, that CSS can be used to adapt for a pages for different presentations or different output medias. At that time, the CSS page design is often referred to as responsive design. Responsive design. Suppose when I'll show it this Google page. Suppose when I start with google.com, when I minimize it, all these things will be clumsy. I mean, it will come to the near, it will be see, even though if I minimize it, all these things will come into your one you can see it in a single page only. This is what your response you design. When I maximize it or when I minimize it also, everything will be coming to the picture. That is what your response you design. That is what you can call it as your output flexibility. Next, improved accessibility. What do you mean by an improved accessibility? Where we have the data in your sites, it is more accessible, which is enriched experience we have, where you can accessible of your web pages, everything easily. That's what we have improved accessibility. Have you understood what you mean by CSS and the advantages of CSS?
Yes, sir.
Now, there are some three different types of CSS. That is what we are going to call it as a location of CSS. Location of CSS. There are three levels we have. Can anyone say that what are the three levels we have? Can anyone say that what are the three levels we have for that? Three levels are nothing but, first one is your inline. First one is inline. Second one is document. Second one is document. Third one is external. Okay, there are three different tier levels of CSS. One is inline style sheet, document level style sheet, and external level style sheet. Kindly have a look on it. What are the three different types of CSS they may ask, or what are the different locations of CSS? Both are one and the same, inline, document, and external. Okay. Now we will see one by one. Can anyone say that what do you mean by an inline style sheet? What do you mean by an inline style sheet? Inline style sheet is nothing but, suppose we have a paragraph tag. Okay, for this paragraph tag, I have some content which is hello or something, and I'm closing P. For this hello, I want to specify my font size should be some 15 pixels. Where my font family should be Times New Roman. Like this, I want to set the properties. When I'm setting the properties individually for each tag, for that we are going to call it as inline style sheet. Understood? When I'm setting the properties, yes. When I'm setting the properties for each tag, for that we are going to call it as inline style sheet. I'll show it out here. Like example, I have a body tag. In this, I have a P. Where I want to specify some attributes for this. Before specifying the attributes, first we have to specify style is equal to double quotes font size colon 15 pixels semicolon font family colon, double quotes, I'll write it Arial. Now I'll give a semicolon, now I'll close it, now I'll specify here it is, hi, hello, good morning. I'll close my this P tag. Now again I am going to write with a P tag. Now I want to specify another type of properties. again I'll specify style is equal to font color colon, I'll write red, semicolon colon, close it, web technology and its applications. It's not font color, it is just a color. And applications, I'll specify it. Just I'll close again a P. That's it. When I'm specifying the properties for each tag, that we are going to call it as an inline style sheet. I'm going to save it inline.html. Save. Now go back to your programs, search varies inline, double click on it, where you can check it out. Hi, hello, good morning, and web technology and its applications. One second. Here I have specified it as 30 pixels, or I'll make it as some 30 points. I'll specify it. I'll refresh it. Here also does seem. Give me 1 minute.
Sir, the spelling of style is wrong.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. See, now it works out. Hello, good morning. You know, it is in the Arial format. Now it is 30 points. Have you understood what do you mean by an inline style sheet?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now the same thing, now we'll move to the next level style sheet. What is the next level style sheet?
Document.
Document level style sheet. See, document level style sheet, we need to have a header part. Header part. Suppose you think here we have a tag called P. The same thing I'm going to, hi, hello, good morning, I'll close it. The same thing here I'll specify H3, I'll specify web technology and its applications. H3. Okay, now if I want to specify properties for P tag and H3 tag, this has to be done in your header part. The document level style sheet says that the properties which you want to apply for the tags, those properties have to be applied in the header part only. In the document level, you have to apply the properties only in the header part. Okay, how? In the sense, first you have to make use of a tag called style tag. Okay, you have to make use of style tag. In the style tag, you have to specify the attribute type is equal to text bar CSS. Can anyone say that why I am going to specify this attribute type is equal to text bar CSS? Why I am specifying, in the sense, the whatever the content which I am writing within the style tag, it is a text but that represents the CSS. The text content, whatever it is there, that represents your cascading style sheet data. Okay, Now I want to apply some attributes, some properties for P tag. So how you need to be apply in the sense P open flower parenthesis, close your flower parenthesis. In this you have to apply your properties like font hyphen family is equal, colon times New Roman semicolon font size colon 30 pixels colon. If you don't have, if you are not interested to give any other attribute, then you need not to give semicolon here. Okay. If you want to give any other attribute, you can give semicolon here. We'll give color colon, we will give blue. That's it. Okay, now again we will move for your H3 tag. Again, I'll close it here. Now what I'll specify, font family colon Arial font hyphen size colon, I'll write it here, 10 points. That's it. Now save your document with some name, document.html.
Sir, in H3 font size, you don't give semicolon there, sir.
One second, Manisha.
Yes, sir.
Where?
H3 font size, sir. Semicolon.
That's what I had said, no? If you have any other property to specify here, you can give a semicolon here. If you don't have any other property to specify here, you need not to give.
Okay, sir.
Understood what I've said?
Yes, sir.
Now we'll go for here and we'll check for document. Now we'll click it. Yeah, you can check it out. Hello, good morning. It is in the blue color. We have specified here Times New Roman 30 pixels and blue color. Now it is in your 30 pixels, blue color and your Times New Roman. Here I have specified 10 points and Arial. It is in the 10 points and now it is in your Arial format. Is it clear?
Yes.
Everyone have understood about inline and the document level?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we will move to your external style sheet. Now in the external style sheet, what we have to do in the sense, whatever we have written in the header part, that you have to store it in your another file. That's it. Whatever you have written in your header part, that you have to store it in your other part, another file. Rest everything will be same. Now you can ask me a question, how to connect from the external CSS file to this file? In the sense, we have a syntax here like this, link rel is equal to style sheet type is equal to text bar CSS and href is equal to whatever the file name we will give there, that file name we have to give here. So I'll mention here px1.css, I'll mention it and I'll self close it. This understood? Okay, in the header part, we have to specify the link, which file we have to access here. Okay, now what I'll do, I'll open another one notepad. Here I'll specify my properties which I have done for them. Can check it out here. Okay, now I have a P tag and H3 tag. For this, I'll save it as ex1.css. Whenever you are storing your CSS file as separately, you have to give extension as .css. .css you have to be specified. Now I will save it this file. Now I have two files. Whatever ex1 file I have specified here in the relationship. Now I'll go back to my external file and I'll execute. Now you can check it out. Hi, hello, good morning. Times New Roman, 30 pixels, blue color. Arial, 10 pixels. Is it clear for everyone? Inline, document, and external?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? Anyone yes, have a doubt? Yes, Ashwini, any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. We'll stop it here today and we'll continue in the next class. Thank you.
Thank you.